Well, hello everyone. Hope you're all doing well. We're back here at the Organ Piper on a Monday, doing some work on the Mighty Wurlitzer, and thought that it was kind of time for another little update for all of you. Sort of an update. Well, first of all, we're still open. We're still doing business. It's been great to have folks out during this time, as scary as it may be out here in the world. Been playing every night and having a lot of fun. After I made the little chamber tour a couple of months ago, we had some feedback and people asking that I would make a video and talk a little bit about the console here, and so this one is for you. Before I get into that, I want to thank everybody that was able to tune in and catch the holiday concert that we did on YouTube here on the channel. Had a lot of people were able to view that, and certainly glad that y'all enjoyed it. And to all of you that were buying CDs and contributing to that that little gift page, really we appreciate it more than you can possibly know. The console here at the Organ Piper was built by the Wurlitzer Company back in 1929. It originally controlled Wurlitzer Opus 2085. That instrument was installed in the Seneca Theater in Buffalo, New York in 1929. I don't know, the dates are a little bit fuzzy to me as to when that particular instrument was removed from the theater, but I do know that later on it was installed in the, I want to say, Skate Haven Roller Rink in Lackawanna, New York, and entertained people while they were roller skating there for a number of years. From the rink, it actually went to another pizza restaurant like the one that we're in today down in Texas, where it played an instrument. Actually, the Seneca organ, I believe, was still intact at that point. After the pizza restaurant closed, the mechanical components, so the chests and the console and the regulators and that kind of, those kind of components were actually purchased by the late great Fred Hermes. Those of you that are kind of in the theater organ world will recognize that name as the gentleman who owns the Michigan Theater Wurlitzer, the five-manual Michigan Theater Wurlitzer. That means that the console actually on his organ has five keyboards, whereas this one only has three. Fred bought this console and the mechanical components from the Seneca organ, and the console was expanded greatly and then installed in the Avalon Theater here in Bayview, which is one of the Milwaukee neighborhoods. The theater is still there. It's back open again, sadly, though no organ, at least at this point, but maybe someday. After the organ that was in the Avalon came out, well, I should say, tell a little more backstory on that. This console was used to greatly expand the Avalon organ. The basis of that organ was three manuals, three keyboards, and eight sets of pipes. And Fred decided that he wanted to expand that instrument and had it up to, I believe it was somewhere around 27 ranks or 27 sets of pipes played from this console, which has many more stop tabs to be able to control that much organ. In 2004, the theater was dark and there was a concern about some vandalism in the theater, and before the organ was damaged, it was decided that the organ was going to be taken out, and so the Organ Piper was able to acquire the console, and it's been playing here in the restaurant ever since. Back in 2012, we did a major kind of restoration on it, re-specified the console to control the instrument here at the Organ Piper a little bit better. We refinished the case and did a lot of rebuilding work. But this console is very interesting in the fact that it has been in a public venue its entire existence. Many of the theater pipe organs that are still existent today have spent, especially the ones that have moved around, have spent periods of time either in storage or in private homes, in private venues where they maybe weren't played as much. But this particular console has been played almost every day for basically its entire life. So she's got a lot of miles on her, and we keep rebuilding things and keep restoring things just to keep it playing. And it plays the instrument here at the Organ Piper very, very well. A little bit more about the console. The original organ, the original Seneca Theater organ, only had 15 sets of pipes, and so there were quite a few less stop tabs up here, these colorful tablets that control the various sounds on the organ. And so it was expanded when it went into the pizza restaurant, the first pizza restaurant, and then it was expanded even more when it went into the Avalon Theater. So it's changed quite a bit from what it was originally, but the shell and the wooden parts, these stop rails, and I believe some of the stop tabs and keyboards and pedal board and swell shoes and all of that kind of stuff, all original to the Seneca organ. As far as how the stop tabs were added, for those of you that are kind of in the know about how this stuff works, the main stop rails are still pneumatic, so when we push a piston, you still get the classic thump, and then the back rail and the partial stop rails are Sendine stop action SAMs. So that's how they were able to, Fred was able to expand the console so much and use the original pneumatic action for a good part of it. The current relay is Z-tronics. The current combination action is a Sterling, although within the next couple of months, hopefully, we've got a Z-tronics combination action coming that's going to be a little bit more reliable for us and be a little more flexible going forward into the future. So very excited to get that installed and get that up and running and kind of increase our flexibility with the combination action. When I say combination action, what I mean is that down under the keyboards, the little round buttons called combination pistons, we're actually able to set those. And when we push the pistons, it turns groups of stops on and off, and it enables us to have sounds very, very quickly. And you can get from something very loud to very soft with just a press of a button, and you can do great musical effects that way. Let's see, there are, right at the moment, there are 234 of those stop tabs. There are 361 note keyboards. The pedal board is 32 notes. And then with the junk tray over on the side here that controls a number of sound effects and bird whistles and car horns and bells and whatever else you can think of, and then all of the lighting controls, there's 136 other miscellaneous controls, combination pistons and all of that kind of stuff. So you're getting close to actually counting all of the keys individually. There's close to 600 individual sort of buttons and things to push and all sorts of stuff on the console. So here's a little shot that you don't normally get to see when the front is on the console. I've taken one of the front panels off here so that you can actually look in and see what makes the stops move up and down. So there is on the back of each stop tab, there's that little arm. And there's one of these little pneumatics right here, and that inflates. There's actions in the back that cause that to inflate when we push one of those piston buttons, and those turn the stops on and off. You can see the upper row there. If I push a piston, you can see that little pneumatic jump up and down, and that's what turns those stops on and off. And then there's actually a set of contacts there that make, and we've done something a little bit unorthodox here To make the console a little bit more reliable, a number of years ago, when we did the last rebuild here, we actually converted from contact wires, which the original console would have, over to reed switches, and there's a little magnet on the arm that actually activates those. It's made the console extremely reliable, whereas I used to actually have to come in here and adjust little contact fingers and clean contacts and stuff at least once a week. Now, maybe a couple, two, three times a year, maybe I have to come in and do some adjustments inside here, and it keeps it playing very well. Like I say, this console has always been in a public venue. It's always been used. It's kind of had a rough life. You know, it's been a workhorse that has been used to make people money for its entire life. So there's a few things about it that are maybe not as museum quality as we might like it to be, but slowly but surely we go through and restore things and improve things and make it all better and better. And she's a great console and a lot of fun to play, a very comfortable console, and I wouldn't trade her for anything in the world. Well, that's a little bit about our Wurlitzer console here at the Organ Piper. Glad that you could join us. Glad that you could watch and maybe learn a little bit about what makes this instrument tick. We certainly look forward to seeing you sometime in the very near future, hopefully here in the dining room. Like I say, hopefully there's a little light at the end of the tunnel. And well, we're here, we're playing, we're having a lot of fun, and take care. See ya. Thank you.